dedication to the Liberal family will never wane. I've always been, and I've always been at the service of our party, today, tomorrow, and always. Nous serons en opposition forte. Plus de 100 députés. Notre dédication est forte afin de défendre les intérêts de notre pays, le Canada. I am so grateful to the people of La Salle et Marne, and I am so grateful to Liberals across this great land who gave me the chance to be Prime Minister. But let me tell you, the one thing that we Liberals have always understood is that it is a great privilege, c'est un privilège, to serve Canada. Thank you very much.
Election night 2006, Montreal, the most challenging speech of Paul Martin's career. Some would later call it his best. Dignified, graceful, composed, Martin announced his resignation as leader of the Liberal Party of Canada. It was the end of a chapter, but not of a story. Paul Martin a été investi 21e Premier ministre du Canada le 12 décembre 2003. Il a mis peu de temps à mettre en œuvre ses priorités. L'une d'elles était de lutter contre la pauvreté des Autochtones, qui est une honte pour notre pays.
Canada's prosperity is shared by Canada's Aboriginal people.
3 months into office, Martin convened his senior ministers and leaders of the First Nations, Inuit and Métis Nation. His goal? To start bringing an end to third world conditions in a first world country.
Et je pense que ce qui maintenant est important, c'est qu'on perd pas de temps. C'est qu'on met le plan.
Mr. Martin lived up to every word that he spoke to me about his commitment regarding First Nations people.
These gaps between Aboriginal Canadians and other Canadians are not acceptable in the 21st century.
He gave us hope and dignity, and that is so important to us.
L'accord de Kelowna représentait l'importance qu'il attachait à cette question, et son engagement n'a pas changé aujourd'hui.
All members of this house, for the sake of our Aboriginal people and the future of our great country, to support this bill.
Another goal, the creation of a national program of early learning and child care. Martin always said the deficit was eliminated for a purpose, so government could invest in the next generation.
Through his leadership, we got child care on the public agenda. It was Paul Martin influencing the caucus that children mattered and that we should do something about child poverty.
Il n'y a pas de pays civilisé qui ne peut pas avoir quelque chose d'important comme investissement dans le développement de la petite enfance. C'est aussi un programme qui a été tué presque personnellement par Harper.
C'est cette logique qui a poussé Paul Martin à vouloir et à établir un plan de 10 ans pour améliorer les soins de santé. To end the yearly squabbles about federal funding, and reform public health care so it would be there for Canada's aging population.
Know that we are working together to preserve and strengthen the health care system. We're a nation of minorities, and in a nation of minorities, it is important that you don't cherry pick rights. A right is a right.
One of the issues that would come to define Martin's time in office was same-sex marriage. Some in his caucus opposed the bill to enshrine it. Mais Paul Martin a affirmé que c'était une question reliée à la charte et que le principe d'égalité devait être respecté. Selon lui, le souci de justice sociale est ce qui définit tout vrai libéral.
He is a man of faith who was able to express his faith in very controversial times and very difficult times, and was a man who was able to say he stands for something that's worthwhile. And standing for something for worthwhile, that's what I believe a Catholic is all about. So I was very proud to be his friend and to be able to support him on many of the issues. We can have a difference of opinion, we can have different ways of expressing it, but I admire him for his courage.